Migration would be cut by 25% under a coalition government. That promise coming in the opposition leader Peter Dutton's budget reply speech tonight as he vowed to get the country back on track. Network political editor Ashleigh Raper joins me now. And Ash, Peter Dutton says slashing migration will help solve the housing crisis.
Ursula, the opposition leader has announced that if the coalition wins the next election, the permanent migration program will be slashed by a quarter to bring in 140,000 people a year. It had also cut refugee arrivals and set a cap on foreign students. And yes, this is linked to housing. He says more housing has to be freed up for Australians, and that can be done by allowing fewer people to come here. A coalition government would also slap a two-year ban on foreign investment and temporary residents buying existing homes in Australia. Now, it should be pointed out that the Albanese government is already working to significantly decrease migration. But Peter Dutton, what he is proposing goes further. Labor also plans to cap foreign students, but the numbers haven't been finalised. The opposition leader insists he'd restore the dream of home ownership. Here he is delivering his budget reply speech.
We believe that by rebalancing the migration program and taking decisive action on the housing crisis, the coalition can free up almost 40,000 additional homes in the first year and well over 100,000 homes in the first 5 years.
And Ash, it's clear he's trying to position himself as tough on crime and tough on what he says is wasteful government spending. Did he say what he would cut if he was PM?
He made it clear he certainly wouldn't go through with the tax incentives for private companies to attract investment in hydrogen and critical minerals that were announced in Tuesday's budget. They don't come in for a couple of years, so they would be dead if the coalition wins the next election. He also did go into law and order territory, which is usually left to the states. But Peter Dutton, being a former cop, we've seen him talking tough on law and order issues, and he extended on that tonight, saying a coalition government would develop uniform knife laws across jurisdictions and create tougher bail laws. Overall, it was pretty light on policy, this speech, when the coalition has been copping criticism that there has been little policy release and we are a year out from an election. In the speech, he touched on a new tax plan, but there was no details. There was nothing new on the nuclear energy plan when previously it had been suggested it would be released ahead of the budget. So there was more signalling rather than substance in this budget reply speech. Ursula?
Apparently a lot more to come. Thanks, Ash.